हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द पोल साइंस ऑफ क्लास 11 आर्ट्स एंड टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ अ न्यू चैप्टर एंड द टॉपिक इज लेजिस्लेचर एंड इट इज ऑल्सो फ्रॉम अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 3. सो लेट अस प्रोसीड देन. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट लेजिस्लेचर, it is the law making body. So in order to understand legislature, first let us understand that there are two heads under legislature. One is unicameral and the second one is bicameral. So unicameral, as you can see, it is a one chamber, or it can be related to only one house that has only one house or one parliament. So it is having, this unicameral is having, by the word itself it says uni means one, so it has one chamber or one house. So in unicameral, if the parliament, that is national assembly, has only one chamber, it is known as unicameral legislature. As I have told you earlier that it has only one parliament. Examples of countries those who are having unicameral or one chamber or one house, some examples or some countries that are having unicameral legislature are Greece, Finland, Denmark, Sweden, Sri Lanka, etc. So we can say that the countries like Greece, Finland, Denmark, Sweden, Sri Lanka follows unicameral legislature. That means they have only one house, that is the national parliament. Whereas, moving on to bicameral legislature, here we have two chambers, that means two houses of parliament. So, if the parliament, that is National Assembly, has two chambers, it is known as bicameral legislatures. That means they have two assemblies. Therefore, it is known as bicameral. That means bi means two and cameral means type of the legislature. So, the countries having bicameral legislatures are India, United Kingdom, United States of America, Afghanistan and Pakistan, etc. More countries are there, but I have mentioned here examples of five countries each, from the unicameral also and from the bicameral also. So we can say that India, and we as Indian citizens can say that India is having bicameral legislature. That means it has two houses or two parliaments. Clear? So let us proceed by the introduction part. So the legislature occupies an important place in modern state. It is regarded as the most important organ of the government. The legislature represents the general will of the people in the democratic system. The legislative is that organ of government which is primarily concerned with the function of making laws. So if we tell about legislature, the first things that comes in our mind is law-making body. That means legislature is given the responsibility to make laws. So it occupies an important place in modern states. That means state in pole sense language can also be called as the country. So in modern language or in modern world, the legislature holds a special place in the governance of a country. It is regarded as the most important organ of the government, and legislature is regarded as one of the most important organ. Why? Because it make laws. The legislature represents the general will of the people in the democratic system. The legislature is that organ of the government which is primarily concerned with the functioning of making laws. So why it is concerned, or why it is termed as the most important organ? Because whatever laws and policies it makes, it is made keeping in mind or thinking about the people or citizens living in that particular country. So it is looking after the general will. That means as a whole, what the people wants, they are including that in the major policies and laws that are formulated. It provides a basis for working of the executive and judiciary. Unless laws are made, the question of enforcing them or interpreting them does not arise. Thus, it can be said that the executive and judicial organ cannot function without the legislature. So, as we know that there are three organs, namely the legislature, the law-making body, the executive, those who executes law after the making of law, and judiciary, one who is there for resolving the disputes. So, when the legislature will make laws, then only it is certain that the executive and judiciary can function. So, thus it can be said that the executive and judicial organ cannot function without the legislature. So, it is obvious, very clear that without making laws and formulating policies, the work of executive and judicial organ will not be there. So, when the legislature will do their work by making laws, then only the executive can execute the laws, and after that, the judiciary will look after any problems that arise due to the implementation of these laws. So, the judiciary and executive are helpless or cannot function without the legislature. Clear? After that, meaning of legislature means, in bracket you can see parliament. So, the law-making body, the whatever the laws and policies are formulated, these are actually carried out in the parliament. So, meaning of the word parliament is a word derived from the French expression parlement, which means speaking, and Latin word parliamentium, which means talking. So, as you can see here that the word parliament has actually been derived from the French expression parlement, P-A-R-L-E-M-E-N-T. So, this parliament means speaking. This is according to French expression parliament, which tells speaking. And according to the Latin word parliamentium, it means talking. So, both are same things. According to French, it is speaking, and according to Latin word, it is talking. It has come to mean meeting for discussion or talking shop where we can discuss national and international issues. So, in other words, as we can see here that according to French, it is speaking, and according to Latin, it is talking. So, we can also, in other words, term it as meeting for discussion. That means when we are meeting, we are discussing. Or talking shop where we can discuss national and international issues. Clear? That means, in other words, it can also be defined as it's a meeting place for discussing any important topic that can be of national or international importance. Now, moving on to the next point, that is different names of legislature. In India, parliament is known as Sansad. Other nations have their own names, that is Diet in Japan, Congress in US, Parliament in UK, and Knesset in Israel. So, as we can see here that the name of the legislature is also known as the parliament. So, this parliament has different names in different countries. Suppose in India it is known as Sansad. In Japan, it is known as the Parliament of Japan is known as Diet. The Parliament of the United States of America is known as Congress. The Parliament in UK is known as the Parliament only. And the Parliament of Israel is known as Knesset. K-N-E-S-S-E-T. Try to remember this. Clear? So, talking about the Parliament of India, as it is a bicameral legislature, you can see here there are two houses. That is Lok Sabha, that is House of the People, and the Rajya Sabha, that is the Council of States. Clear? There are two houses of parliament, the upper house and the lower house. And in other words, you can also say there are two houses of parliament, namely Lok Sabha, that is the House of the People, where all the members elected in the House of the People are through the vote of ours. And in the Rajya Sabha, it is Council of States. That means these are indirectly elected by the ministers, where it is represented as the Rajya Sabha. It is in case of Parliament, which is also known as Sansad. So, with this, I will wind up today's topic. In today's topic, we have read about the legislature in its two types, where we read about a formal introduction was made, namely about unicameral and bicameral. Then we had learned about the legislature, without whom the judiciary and executive cannot work properly. Then after that, we also read about the derivation of the word parliament. According to French word parliament, it is meant as speaking, and according to Latin word parliamentium, it is known as talking. Or in other words, you can also define in general words like it is a meeting for discussions for various important, it can be national topic also, international issues also. And we have also known about the different names of the legislature, that is parliament, that is in India it is known as Sansad, in Japan it is known as Diet, in US it is known as Congress, in UK it is known as Parliament, and in Israel it is known as Knesset. And lastly, we had gone through the picture of the two houses of the parliament, that is the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, that is related to the country India. So I hope that whatever the points I have made you understand today, it is now clear to you. So with that, I will wind up today's topic. Thank you.